Hello, my dear students. In the last class, we were discussing on different advantages of electric drives. So today, we will also continue with that advantages. So the electric drives have flexible control characteristics and can be employed to automatically control the drive. So as I told you that electric drives are very, very flexible, not only in terms of electrical loading, or versatility of the load, rather also in the directions consideration. So the torque can be positive or negative, and the speed can also be positive or negative. So this is, as we have discussed yesterday, this is another way of achieving flexibility. The other flexibility is loading. So this is number one, this is two. So within the operating limits of the motor, which is quite a wide range, it can be loaded accordingly. So because of the following advantages, the mechanical energy already available from a non-electrical prime mover is sometimes first converted into electrical energy by a generator and back to mechanical energy by an electrical motor. So this is very simple. So suppose this is the prime mover of an electrical machine, and I am giving some mechanical energy input. Let this be a DC machine. So what will happen at the output? You will be getting some voltage. So this is generated mechanically. And what output I am getting? I am getting electrical output. Am I clear? So it is electrical output. But if there is some requirement that I want to get mechanical energy, so I will give electrical power input. So what will happen? As soon as I get some or give some voltage as input, there will be some current that will be flowing through the rotating part and the armature conductors. So what will happen? A magnetic field will be created and the rotor will rotate, and you will be getting torque and speed as output. So these are basically the modes of operation. So an electrical machine can be operated as a generator, or it can be operated as an electrical motor. I guess I'm clear. So an electrical link thus provides between non-electrical prime mover and the load impact to the drive and flexible control characteristics. So electrical link is providing between a non-electric prime mover and the load. So what is happening? You have a load and you have some mechanical energy that you can generate. So the intermediate thing is the generator. And that load has to be driven by the drive. And the control characteristic is very, very flexible. So if you think in case of DC motors, what type of controls are available? So one is phi control, that is the flux control, and another is the RA, or the armature resistance control. This phi is often denoted by phi F, or it is the field flux control. So by these methods we can control the speed. So between the ranges we are getting the speed, and obviously when we are loading, depending on our load requirement, the torque will also change. So So this is all about the advantages of electric drives. Now we will be discussing about the disadvantages of an electric drive. So the most important thing is, till and unless there is electrical power, you will get some output. But as soon as there is a power failure, what will happen? The whole of the system will fail. Because there will be no electricity. If there is no electricity, you cannot apply any voltage. If you cannot apply any voltage, what will happen? There will be no armature current. If there is no armature current, there will be no rotational force. That means tau will be equal to zero and omega will be equal to zero. So power failure is the prime disadvantage. The application of the drive is limited because it cannot be used in a place where power supply is not there. So when power supply is not there, your application cannot be used. You cannot use that drive. So you have to place your drive in such a area or in such a location where power supply is there, because without power you cannot use it. So power supply is not available is a main importance. Secondly, it will cause noise pollution, because if you keep it in the locality, there will be definitely some noise, and the number of drives, if it is more, then more noise will be created. So generally an electric drive is present in industrial area, if you think of wider application. So electric drives are present in industrial areas, not in domestic areas, because noise pollution is one of the prime concerns. Because you see, there is air pollution, there is sound pollution, there is water pollution. These are the three main types of pollution. And noise pollution, if it is caused by some appliance, then you cannot be, or you cannot afford to use it in your normal residential purpose. And here, the initial cost of the system is high. See, one very important thing is that it is the economics of a system. It may have some advantages. It may have some high efficiency. As a result, it may have some high power output. But the thing is, it will not be economic if its cost is very high. So in all the industrial purposes, first a cost-benefit analysis is provided. Suppose there are some engineers, a group of engineers may be coming up with a plan A, which is of X rupees. So this is the group of engineers A. He or she is, or they are coming up with a plan of X rupees. And there is a group of engineers B who is coming up with a plan of Y rupees. Now the efficiency of A is say 90%, and the efficiency of B, that means the product, it is 80%. But if X is very very large than Y, then obviously I will choose Y, even if it is having a lower efficiency than A. So there are many other factors, and if the initial cost of the system is very high, then depending on the application again, I cannot simply use it. So a cost-benefit analysis has to be there, and the payback period, there are many things. These things have to be considered while selecting a drive, or rather selecting the scheme for the drive. So next comes classification of electric drives. So electric drives are mainly classified into three different categories. One is the group drive. Another is the individual drive. Another is the multi-motor drive. Let us see that what these speaks of. So a group drive is consisting of a several group of mechanisms or machines that are organized on one shaft and driven or actuated by one motor. The system is called a group drive or a shaft drive. So number of motors should be equal to 1, but the number of processes or the number of mechanisms is greater than 1. If several group of mechanisms or machines are organized on one shaft and driven or actuated by one motor, the system is called a group drive or a shaft drive. That means the number of shaft is 1 and the number of operations are, or the number of mechanisms are more. That is called a group drive. So the main advantage of a group drive is that it is most economical. This is very important, because you see, what is the number of motors that you are using? It is only 1. And as you are using only a single motor, the electrical energy that is spent is only for one motor. Suppose if the electrical energy spent is set x kilowatt, or rather I would say x kilowatt hour. If the number of motors are 2, then it will be 2x kilowatt hour. So since it is employing a single motor, so it will just give you x kilowatt hour output, or rather it will be using rather x kilowatt hour. So the power that is being used, it is only x kilowatt hour, not 2x kilowatt hour. So the amount of power consumption is very less, and as a result the bill which you will be getting to operate this particular drive is very less, so it is economical. But there are also many disadvantages. Any fault that occurs in driving the motor renders all the driving equipment idle. You see, you are employing only one motor, but if there is some fault in the motor, then what will happen? All the processes that are linked with that motor, it will just become idle. So the thing is that it is not reliable. It is not reliable. Efficiency is low because of the losses occurring in the energy transmitting the mechanisms, that is the power loss. So the efficiency is low, because power losses will be there. The power loss is large. It is not safe to operate, and the noise level at the working spot is high. Why it is not safe to operate? Because you see, if there is some power failure or if there is some problem with the motor, and if the process associated with the drive is very important, then what will happen? If there is some problem, then the entire system will become idle, the entire system will fail. So it is not safe. Also the noise level is very high, because you see, one motor is getting very much stressed, and if the number of processes that are connected with the motors is very large, so what will happen? It will fail, or rather there will be so much noise in the surroundings which will be not desirable. Rather, Next comes an individual drive. So what is an individual drive? If a single motor is used to drive or actuate a given mechanism and it does all the jobs connected with this load, then it is called an individual drive. If a single motor is used to drive or actuate a given mechanism and it does all the jobs connected with this load, it is called an individual drive. All the operations connected with operating a lathe may be performed by a single motor. So suppose let us take the example of a lathe machine. Where have you seen a lathe machine? A lathe machine has been seen in a workshop, an engineering workshop. So if you see a lathe machine, so you will see that a single motor is operating all the operations of a lathe. So each motor is driven by its own separated motor with the help of gears, pulleys. So obviously you have to take the help of gears and pulleys. So the main disadvantage is that power loss is there. Obviously power loss will be there. Power loss is there. Now, next comes is the multi-motor drive. So in a multi-motor drive, each operation of the mechanism is taken care by a separate drive motor. So there is a separate motor for one operation. So if the number of operations is n, the number of motors is also n. The system contains several individual drives, each of which to operates its own mechanism. So individual drives are there, each of which is operating its own mechanism. Separate motors are provided for actuating different parts of the driven mechanism. So separate motors are required for actuating different parts. So what are the advantages? Each machine is driven by a separated motor and it can be run or stopped as desired. So each machine, as it is operated by a separate motor, it can be run or stopped as desired. So machines not required can be shut down. So suppose if there are 10 machines, say, and 3 machines are not required, so you can simply turn off that 3 machines and you can work on 7 machines. And also replaced with minimum of dislocation. So dislocation can be minimum. There is flexibility in the installation of different machines. So as each machine is driven by a separated motor, so what is there? Flexibility is there because you can customize the operation. So in case of motor fault, only its connected machine will stop, where the others will continue working undisturbed. So in case if there is a fault, only one connected machine will stop and the other will continue to work undisturbed. That means reliability is there. So the system is reliable. And since each operation is taken care by each motor, so the number of belts, line shafts greatly reduces the risk of accidents to the operating personnel, because each motor is taking care of each process. But the disadvantage is you are employing large number of motors, so the cost is very high. The cost will be very high. Thank you.